Hi, my name is Inga Urbansik McKenney, and I am talking to you a little bit today about my interview that I had with Dr. Supriya Bailey. I chose Dr. Bailey primarily because of her research interests in female education and empowerment in South Asia, which is a very similar interest of mine. We had our interview via Zoom, and we recorded the interview, and we talked about so many exciting things. However, for the purpose of this assignment, I wanted to share two main ideas with you that I think will help you as well along your way. So primarily, I asked Dr. Bailey about her role as a researcher internationally, and how can she be sure that the responses that she is getting from her subjects are honest, let's say, so to speak, honest in the sense of that they're not necessarily just answering to her the way they think she would want them to answer, knowing that she is an American woman or whatever preconceived notions the subjects might have. So this question sparked a very long discussion on our end. And just to summarize, there were three key areas that Dr. Bailey addressed. The first is called reflexivity, the second, positionality, and the third is intersectionality. So I'm sharing with you, as you go about as a researcher, Dr. Bailey is suggesting, first of all, as a researcher, we need to practice reflexivity, which means that we ourselves need to be aware of the privileges or, you know, that we have or experience as the researcher. How are we coming in to this scenario? And positionality, meaning that we need to be aware as well of where we are an outsider. So once we take a look at reflexivity and positionality, we might be able to see then and understand how these aspects of our identity bump up against local identities in our research. And furthermore, she discussed the idea of intersectionality, which is a phrase termed by Kimberly Crenshaw. And this states that we are no one identity at any given time. So we can be walking around thinking one day that I'm a professor, or I'm a student, or I'm an American, or I'm a mother, or I'm a daughter, or a sister, or a friend. So we have many different identities, and we don't know which prism people are viewing us. So they can be looking at us with multiple prisms of identity and not just responding to one. So it's important for us to recognize this when we are collecting data or doing a study. We have to understand that people might be looking at us through this prism. And our job as a researcher is to recognize through which prisms, okay, they're looking at us and be aware of this. So Dr. Bailey summarized this idea with a great quote from her, which I quoted directly. She says that there is no such thing as boxing people into the space where you think you are in. There's no such thing as boxing people into the space you think they think you are in. Something to think about as a researcher. So that's one idea. Secondly, kind of on a lighter note, I asked her in summary, you know, if she had some advice for us as we are just starting this PhD program, what advice does she wish that she had been given when she was just starting out, and what would she like to give to us? And basically, she indicated that really the best thing that happened for her that she encourages us to do is to find someone to work with, to motivate each other, to encourage and support each other. This will help us through. Find someone who will continue to inspire us, to push us, hold us accountable, and to develop systems of organization early on. So these are just some tips that I got from my interview. There was so many more interesting things that I learned about Dr. Bailey and her research, but specifically for this assignment, I'd like to share these with all of you. So thank you again for listening, and I hope you have a great day.